students, welcome back to the chapter His First Flight. We had started the story about a seagull who was afraid of flying, who doesn't want to fly. His whole family members, his brother, his sisters who were younger than him, they flew away with the family, and the mother, father, brother and sisters, they were just encouraging him, persuading him. They are getting angry, sometimes taunting him, probably in order to encourage him to fly, but he was so much afraid that he didn't take any step. Now what happened, you see, the sun was now ascending the sky, so it was a sunny day, blazing on his legs that faced the south. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. So almost for 24 hours he didn't eat anything. His family had left, and even mother and father, they were not much interested in providing food to him, and as he was left alone, that's why he didn't eat anything. That maybe because of this reason he was feeling so much heat. He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge. Brink, I have already given you the meaning. Brink means edge, E-D-G-E. Edge means kinara. So he reached there and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wings, and he stood there. He closed one eye, then the other. So now, probably he was waiting for his family. He just wanted to gain their attention. He just wanted to convey that he didn't eat anything. He was hungry. That's why probably he had gone there and waiting for his family members. And pretended to be falling asleep. Pretending means what? What do you mean by pretend? To show, dikhawa karna, falling asleep. So he was just showing that he was sleeping there, but it was not like that. He was just waiting for his family members. Probably he was just thinking that his mother will pay attention to him, his father will pay attention to him, probably they will provide him food. That's why he was waiting for that. Still, they took no notice of him. But nobody was paying attention to him. His family members were not paying attention to him. The reason was that they just wanted to persuade him. They just wanted to encourage him to take a jump, to take a dive. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau dozing. What do you mean by dozing? It means having a nap, jhapki lena, with their heads sunk into their necks. So he found that the brother and sisters, after having their meal and flying high with the parents, they were feeling very satisfied, and probably because of this reason, they were enjoying the nap. Wo aaram kar rahe the, nap le rahe the, jhapkiyan le rahe the. His father was preening. Preening means making an effort to maintain feathers. Apne feathers ko sajana, savarna with the help of beak. Generally, birds used to do with the help of their beak. They used to make their feathers tidy. Apne jo pankh hai usko tidy karte hain beak ki madad se, chonch ki madad se. So his father was preening the feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. He found that his mother was noticing him, his mother was paying attention to him. He became happy. Maybe the mother will bring food for me. She was standing on a high little hump. Hump means what? Round shaped lump. Hump means a round shaped lump. Ubhra hua gol bhag jo hota hai, jaise kubar nikla hota hai. On plateau, it was like a hump, round-shaped hump you can say, round-shaped lump you can say, on the plateau. Her white breast thrust means what? Moving into a direction suddenly forward. So the mother was just standing on it. Now and again, she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet. So mother was just enjoying with a fish that she has taken, that she has dived, and probably she had caught that for eating, and she was just tearing it, and then trapped. The word is for your homework students is trapped. Again, I'm telling this word is your homework is trapped. Each side of her feet on the rock. So now he is just getting his beak more sharp. The sight of the food maddened him. When he saw his mother tearing the fish, he got mad. Why did he get mad? The reason is that he was very much hungry. He didn't eat anything almost for 24 hours. That's why. So that's why when he saw the fish with mother who was tearing it, she got mad completely. How he loved to tear food that way, scrapping his beak now and again to wet it. So कैसे he was just imagining and he was just imagining the days when he used to tear fishes in the way the mother used to do now and the way he used to sharp his beaks. So now he was imagining all these things. He was just thinking about his days that he spent with his family, and that's why now he was just getting mad to get the food. Maybe he had just ray of hope that the mother will bring food for him. Now he tried begging her to bring him some food. Now he started calling the mother. He just started crying. He just started calling his mother to bring some food for him. He was just willing to gather some emotions from her mother. She screamed back. Screamed means what? That is a long high pitched cry sound. तेज आवाज में साउंड निकालना. Scream back. Derisively. Derisively means what? It's like in a manner showing someone that he or she is stupid. So just taunting somebody that he is just a fool. So although she was just screaming back, but the behavior was different. And the emotion was different that she was showing to him. She was not happy with the child. Mother उस समय उस बच्चे से खुश नहीं है क्योंकि उसे घुना नहीं आता और वो घुना सीखना भी नहीं चाहता है. That's why she was taunting. वो उस पर ताना मारने की कोशिश कर रही है, उसका मजाक उड़ाने की कोशिश कर रही है. But he kept calling plaintively. What do you mean by plaintively? It means in sad manner. दुखी होकर मदर को कॉल करता है. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. And just here the scream, it means a loud, long, loud sound with emotions. Here, sad emotions. Here, the emotions full of joy. So, yeah, within few minutes, he just started screaming joyfully. What was the reason? His mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. When he saw the mother was coming with the food for him, he became very happy. He started screaming. He just started showing his happiness to the mother. So what happened? We found today that the she-bull was there. He didn't eat for so long. That's why he was got mad because of excess of hunger. And he found his brothers and sisters. After having their food, they were enjoying their nap. Nobody was paying attention to him. Only the mother was paying attention. He just called the mother. And what happened? The mother replied. Now the mother was coming to him with food. Now see what happened. He leaned out. What do you mean by leaned out? Jhukna? Bent? So he leaned out eagerly, anxiously tapping the rock with his feet. Why did he tap the rock with his feet? Because he was showing his happiness. He was so much happy that he was tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to his mother as she flew across. And now he just wanted to get nearer and nearer to the mother. But when she was just opposite to him, she halted. Halted means she stopped. When she reached near to the child, she stopped there for few moments, her wings motionless. So now there was no motion in her wings, and she stopped there on the way, very much near to the child, a little bit away. The piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. Very little distance they had. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering, just thinking, pondering, why she did not come nearer. And then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. You see, this light is very powerful light, students. It will give you the mantra of the life. What happened? The mother came near to him, very much nearer to him, but she halted. Now she was not moving towards him. He became very surprised. He was shocked. The mother is not coming to me. What is the reason? Now what happened? He saw the piece of fish. Now the piece of fish had maddened him completely. He was unable to tolerate he was unable to bear his hunger. And that's why, just because of this hunger, he just took a dive. The bird who was so much afraid of flying, the bird who was just covered himself in a shell. Now what happened? It came out. What happened? When you have hunger of getting something, when you are hungry to achieve your goal, when you have that hunger to prove yourself, then nobody can stop you, nobody can check you. There will be troubles, no doubt, but you find that you have that stamina to cover it, you have that stamina to fight, and you have that stamina to come out. You will find the solutions, you will find the way, and certainly you will excel. You will come out with the flying colors. The same happened with this bird, that the bird was afraid of flying, was afraid of the flapping of wings even. Now it took a dive at the fish because it was maddened by the hunger. So students, it's very much important to keep your hunger alive. Hunger for what? You should be hungry to achieve something, and if it is there, if you are hungry to achieve something, certainly you will achieve. The same happened with this bird. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. For the first time he took that dive, for the first time he tried to fly, that's why probably the scene was created. Then a monstrous terror seized him. He was completely clutched by the terror, the fear, because for the first time he took that dive, he started flying, but suddenly he realized, oh, what happened? I am not knowing how to fly, and now I started flying. And that's why the terror has seized him. He was caught in terror. Wo dar se bilkul dar charon taraf se dar se gir gaya, and his heart stood still. And it seems that his heart had was not beating. It seems like that. Laga ki uski dhadkan ruk gayi dar se. He could hear nothing. But it only lasted a minute. But just for few minutes, this situation happened. This thing he faced. But after that, he left everything and he started flying. It happened with us, students. It happened with you. It happens with everybody. Why? Because we all are afraid of anything, something. And what we have to do, I have told already, in order to come out from the terror, we have to terrorize the terror. Dar ko dara ke bhagana hoga. Only then we can achieve something in our life. The chapter is telling the same. So, but it only lasted a minute. The next moment, he felt his wings spread outward. And suddenly he found his wings were just supporting him. They were started supporting him. His wings were supporting him. The wind rushed against his breast, heated then under his stomach. Now his wings were opened. and against his wings. He could feel the tip of his wings cutting through the air. And now he started flying. He just started facing air, cutting the air, passing and just flying high in the sky. He was not falling headlong down. What do you mean by headlong? Headlong means what? Sir ke bal. Ab wo sir ke bal nahi gir raha tha because he knew how to take a dive, how to fly. He was soaring gradually. It means what? Moving down suddenly, downwards and upwards. So soaring was going on, but he did. He tried. He did. He was no longer afraid. But once he tried, now he started loving flying. He was not afraid, not at all. He just felt a bit dizzy. Dizzy means what? A bit uncomfortable, probably losing the balance. Because for the first time he did that thing, for the first time he tried to fly, that's why a bit uncomfortable he was. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared upwards. फिर से उसने मूवमेंट किया ऊपर की तरफ and then started making sound with happiness. So till here we are completing today, students. Today's lesson is to you have to be hungry to achieve in your life. Now you are a student of standard 10. You have to take your board examination next year. This year is very very crucial. This is high time to study, students, and your homework for today is write one paragraph how to keep your just 1 minute sir, isko yahan se cut kijiye to. How can you terrorize the terror? Students, you have to write one paragraph. How can you terrorize the terror? And is there any incident that can prove that you had terrorized the terror? Aapko ek essay likhna hai, ek paragraph likhna hai jisme how can you terrorize the terror? Dar ko kaise dara ke bhaga sakte hain? The next thing, is there any incident that happened in your life that can prove that you have terrorized the terror? This is your homework for today, students. Have a nice day.